Hello and welcome to BSTV. My name is Afshan Khan. The recent custodial death of a father and son in Tamil Nadu has attracted a huge amount of public interest, and the police reform debate has yet again come to the forefront. I believe that any debate on police reform without discussing the case study of Mohammad Aamir's life is not complete. So who's Mohammad Aamir? In this video, I'm going to review the book Framed as a Terrorist, My 14-Year Struggle to Prove My Innocence by Mohammad Aamir Khan and Nandita Haksar. Nandita Haksar at the beginning of the book writes that police reform in India is only possible with moral outrage against institutionalized form of tortures and brutalities. But instead, in India, we see that more people and majority of the people are in support of giving more power to police, which will only worsen the situation. This book is the story of a young man whose youth was destroyed due to wrongful confinement for 14 years as a terrorist. He lost his dreams, his career, his parents, and everything due to injustice. The book was first published by Speaking Tiger Publications in 2016, and this is quite affordable. The story of the book starts with the picturization of Old Delhi that we know today as Delhi 6. It tells the story of its breaking and making. At the time of partition, Mohammad Aamir's family decided to stay with India and not go to Pakistan. At that time, it was usual to go to Pakistan, and people used to come from there also. When he grew up, he wished to visit his sister's place and he wanted to meet her in Pakistan. One day he was all set to go there. His passport and other documents were prepared. And on his way to home, he meets with a person whose name was Gupta Ji. And Aamir did not know anything about this man. Now, this man asks Aamir to do a task. He tries to convince Aamir that this job is for serving his country. So in order to serve his country, in order to do something for the sake of his country, for the sake of his motherland and nation, Aamir agrees to the offer because Gupta Ji had promised him to provide full security to him and his family. And he also promised that he will provide some financial support to Aamir as well. So he agrees to it only for the sake of his country. Now, when he goes to the station, when he is going to go to Pakistan, Gupta Ji again comes to him and reminds him of his task. He asks him to bring a briefcase from someone in Pakistan and take few pictures, which Aamir, when he go to Pakistan, he was unable to get the pictures. So he get the briefcase from the person. And when he was coming back to India, the custom people were checking everybody's stuff very carefully. So Aamir, out of fear, throws away the briefcase. And because he thought that he could spend the rest of his life in Pakistani jail, and he wanted to come back to India, to his nation. So he throws away the briefcase, he comes back to India. And now his problem starts. Aamir comes back to India and tells Gupta Ji whatever had happened with him. So he tells the truth, but Gupta Ji didn't believe him and he threatened him. He blackmailed him. One day Aamir was on his way to market when he realizes that a white gypsy was coming nearer to him. The speed of the vehicle slows down. It comes nearer to him and he was kidnapped. He was given third degree torture and he was repeatedly asked to submit the briefcase, which he did not have. So Aamir kept telling the truth. He kept telling what had happened to him and why he couldn't do his task. Now we have to understand that Aamir was 20 years old at that time and he didn't get any training for the work that he was assigned for. Now, as Aamir was being tortured again and again continuously, he was asked to sign on black sheets and he refused to do that. and he kept telling the truth. He was not believed, but due to the severe tortures that he had to go through, he succumbs and agrees to sign on the blank sheets and few diaries. So he does that, and now he was unaware of the consequences. Till that time, he was thinking that he has failed as a spy and he couldn't do the job of being an agent of intelligence agencies, and that's why he is being punished. But later only he realizes that 19 false terror cases have been filed against him and he is framed as a terrorist for the bomb blast that took place almost a year ago. From that time begins his journey of proving his innocence. The thing which grieved him the most was to see his parents being helpless and being stigmatized in the society for being called as the parents of a terrorist. So these things grieved him a lot, to see every time their parents coming to attend the hearing, and he could see the helplessness that his parents were going through, the helplessness that he was feeling. But at the same time, what helped him to do the struggle against injustice was his parents' hope and Alia's love. So Alia was his childhood love, whom he wanted to get married, but he gets married to her after his release, after 14 years of his struggle to prove his innocence. And Alia waited for him for 14 long years. Now, the story of the book is much, much more than what I just said. It is more complex. The emotions and feelings of Aamir are not easy to express in words. So I want all of you to read this book and understand the various aspects that this book provides to us. And this book also teaches us many, many little things that we ignore. Like when you do the case study of Aamir's life, you would realize that how our judicial system works, how the intelligence agencies work, the question of accountability and transparency of intelligence agencies, how the methods of torture used by police officers have been normalized, and how this violates the human rights of the prisoners. What is the life of a prisoner? How is the world inside the prison and outside the prison? So this book teaches us a lot more things. It also tells us how the attitude of jailers and officers within the prison changes with a change in scenario outside the jail. It also teaches us what kind of behavior they have with the lower class people and those who belong to marginalized section of society. And Mohammad Aamir also argues that most of the times those youth are framed who belong to poor families, who cannot afford a good lawyer. In the last part of the book, he also discusses his struggle after coming out from the jail, and it teaches us on how the rehabilitation of someone who was framed as a terrorist is so difficult. And Aamir had to create a whole new world for himself, because after 14 years, see, this boy was picked up at the age of 20 and he was released when he was 34. So in this time span of 14 years, everything had changed and he could see a whole new world outside, and he had to struggle for getting a job, for the betterment of his family. So he himself creates a new world. In short, we can say that his struggle did not end with his release from jail. Let me read few lines from the page number 204, where Aamir writes what he was feeling at the time he was released. So when it was declared that he is free and he comes out of the jail, he writes, "It was evening and no one was there to receive me. The key turned in the big lock, the door opened, and I stepped out with a bag in my hand and took a deep breath. I turned left and then to the right. There were no guards. I had no handcuffs, and I was truly free. I was alone, but I was free. I looked up at the sky and turned left and walked in that direction. I went back and turned to the right and walked in that direction. I was so thrilled I could walk in any direction, and no one was there to tell me where to go. I wanted to feel my freedom. I turned back one last time to look at the gate of the jail and the tower and walls. I did not look back again. Apart from the pain that you feel throughout reading this book, the book also gives you a lot of hope and positivity. And this is where I believe we all should be proud of Mohammad Aamir, and we all should be thankful to him for being such a positive person throughout his struggle, for being such a positive person even after coming out from the jail and facing a lot of difficulties and hardships. He still remains so positive. I'm so glad to share this with all of you that Mohammad Aamir currently works for human rights. He works for justice, he has also worked for police reforms, and currently he's heading a project on juvenile justice. So I think his life is such a big lesson for all of us. We all have to learn a lot from him. Framed as a Terrorist is one of those books which makes you cry. So, speaking about my experience in the last week when I read this book, I could not think of anything else than Aamir's life and his story, and I kept thinking about each and every details that he has provided in the book. In short, I can say that this is a brutally honest and painful story, and this book dares to speak the truth. Now I want each one of you to read this book, to share Aamir's story with your friends and family members, and do share this video. We'll be back with a new book in the next video. Till then, thanks and take care of yourself.